Factoring tricks, sum and difference of cubes. So let's look at sum of cubes first. This is another one of those polynomials that if you don't know the formula, you cannot factor it. So this is one of those you got to commit to memory. So when we're doing the sum of cubes, first thing is that we always are going to just write the basis with whatever the sign is there. So in this case, a plus b. Then we square the first term, do the opposite sign, take a times b, and then plus b squared. One thing that you might find helpful, for those of you that like acronyms and things like that, is we have an acronym called SOAP. And it's basically talking about our signs in our factors. So S stands for same. O is opposite. A is always. And P is for positive. So same, opposite, always positive. We have the difference of cubes. Again, we start with writing down the base. Square the first term. Opposite sign. A times B plus B squared. Some of this might help if you have it written in words. So here's what it is. Write down bases with same sign. Okay. Then we take and square first term. Opposite sign. Take first times second term, or you can think of it as the last term if you want, plus the square of second or last term. And you're done. If it's helpful to have it written down, there's your thing. If you memorize formulas better, there's your formulas. Now, in order to do cubics, you need to know or recognize cubics. So here's some that we recommend that you have memorized. 1 cubed, 1. 2 cubed is equal to 8. 3 cubed is 27. 4 cubed is 64. 5 cubed is 125. And 6 cubed is 216. You shouldn't have to go above 6 cubed generally. That's usually that's the highest that we go. So if you recognize these as cubics, you should be good to recognize any cubic. All right, so let's take a look at our two examples. Now we have m cubed and we have 125. So first thing that I always do is I write down my bases. So the base of m cubed is just going to be m. The base of 125, well, if we look up here to our cubes worth remembering, we'll see that the base for 125 is 5. And notice I kept the sign that we had originally. Now, continuing with our formula that we have, we're going to square the first term, which would be m squared. Write down the opposite sign, which will be minus. We'll take m times 5, which gives us 5m. We're going to always be positive, so we have plus. And then we square the last term, which is 5 squared, which will give us 25. And I'm done. Nothing else can be factored. Now let's take a look at example 2. Again, what tells me this is a cubic is the fact that I have 3's for my exponent. So, looking back over here at our list, we see that the base for 8 is going to be 2, and the base of a cubed is going to be a. I bring down the sign. I want to keep the same sign. And the base of 27 is 3, and y will be our base for y cubed. So we square the first term, which is going to give us 4a squared. We're going to write down the opposite sign, which will be plus. Then I'm taking 2a times 3a, which will give us 6ay, plus squaring the last term, I get 9y squared. And I'm done. You just have to use your formulas.